In our previous introductory lesson, we have seen how to create the responsive website using HTML, CSS, and Bootstrap, right? We have seen the basic heading tags, paragraph tag, div tag, right? Now, in this session, we are going to deep dive into more tags of HTML, which are very important to understand, right? So, the first thing which we are going to discuss in today's lecture is about HTML list, UL, LI, OL, DL, DT, DD. These are the tags which are used to create the HTML lists. Okay, so UL tag is also called as an unordered list, like this. UL tag is also called as an unordered list because there is no order here. This is do not specifying any order, just a circle. This circle is also called as disk, right? So as you can see here, the HTML required to create a list is UL tags, and inside that you need this list item. LI means list item. Okay, so you can see the output here. This is how you can create the unordered list. By default, the icon here is disk, right? If you want to change the disk with circle, then you can use the list style type attribute. List style type attribute as circle. Similarly, if you want to use the square here, you can use the list style type as square as well, right? By default, the disk is present. If you want to specify it manually, you can do it as well. List style type as disk. Similarly, we have the OL list for ordered list. Why? Because there is some kind of order present. 1, 2, 3. We can count it, but in unordered list, we cannot. Here, the HTML required for ordered list is this OL tag, and inside OL tag we have the list items, and by default the order is 1 2 3 4, like this, in a counting numbers. But if you want to change the style of this, you can do it by using the attribute style attribute, and this is list style type as upper Roman. Now it will change the numbers into the upper Roman formats, like this. Similarly, you can use the upper alpha as well, A, B, C, D. Only you have to specify it upper alpha, it will change the order by default using the OL tag. You can use the lower alpha for lower alphabets as well. So your task here is to apply all these properties manually one by one. For example, first create this UL unordered list, and this will be displayed, right? Then try this list style type as circle, then it will display this kind of format. Similarly, like this for square, you will get this. So try this on your own, you will get better understanding. You can rewind the video and see the types here. Here upper Roman for OL tag, lower alpha, upper alpha, like this, right? Similarly, we have one more list in HTML which is called as description HTML list. So to write the definition, basically this is used. For example, here this is a title and this is a description and this is its definition. So how to create this kind of list? So for that, the HTML required is this definition list, which is denoted by DL, definition list. Inside definition list we have the DT, which is title. So this is science, and inside title we want description, which is denoted by DD, or data, data definition we can say. Okay, so this is one title. This is one title. Inside this we have this definition, and this entire title and definition is inside this definition list. Similarly, inside this definition list we have this one title and we have another title, and inside this title we have definition as well for maths. Like this, you can create your own definition list as well, right? Science and its subject. So this is title, this is DD, and this is title, this is DD, and all the things are inside the DL and between these two tags. So these were the three types of list in HTML: ordered list, unordered list, and description HTML list. Okay, we have seen how to add the input text, right? We have seen this in our previous episode, how to create the text box. Like input text, we have text area as well. Now, what is the basic difference between input type is equal to text and text area? So let's see that. Go to this editor. If you want to use this, you can use this codesify.com old web editor. You can go here. Here we have the basic HTML structure ready. Okay, now we have to check what is the basic difference between input type is equal to text. So this will create the input text box here, right? Here if I give the placeholder as email, similarly if I create one more text here like this, so we have two text boxes here, right? Similarly, if I use the text area now, it is creating more bigger text box for me, right? If I write some value here inside this and enter here, I cannot add the new line inside this text box. Only this much text I can add into this, right? Similarly, here as well, I can only add the text in one line. I cannot use the new line here or cannot add the new line here. But here in case of text area, if I add, this is first line, I can add enter as well. This is second line, I can add third line as well. I can write fourth line, I can add fifth, sixth, I can add as many as lines into this. So a scroll bar is getting, if you notice here, a scroll bar is getting displayed here like this, right? All the content inside this text area will be scrollable. So I hope you got the basic understanding between this input and text area. This is one line text field, this is multi-line text field. You can use the attributes of this text area like this, rows as 20. So these are your rows. This will be considered as a first row. This will be considered as a second row. This will be your third row. This will be your fourth row. Like this, we have 30 rows. It has created the rows automatically, right? Basically, I want to tell you, these are the rows in this format. And these are your columns. These are your columns. If I write calls is equals to 30 as well. So as you can see, the width of this box is changed here. If I write 60 here, the box is getting more bigger. The width here is more now. And the height here is defined by rows and the width by calls. Basic difference between input and text area. I hope this is cleared. We have seen the button tag as well. Button type is equal to button will create the button. Okay, this is simple. How to add the drop down using select tag. So using this select tag, you can add the drop down as well. For example, here as you can see, select, and inside that select we have the options here. This is option value 1, this is option value 2. Like this you can add the drop down into your HTML as well. You can try this into the editor, you will get better understanding about how to add the drop down using the select and option tag. Input type is equal to date. So this will help us to create the date. So let's run this into the editor. If I type input type is equal to date, so as you can see, a date text field is present here. So the entire calendar is appeared here now. So this is the advantage of using the input type is equal to date. So let me run the select tag as well. Select, inside select you can run the option A. Similarly, you can add the options like this, option B, option C and option D. If I click here, a drop down is created here, right? So this is how you can create the drop downs. Yesterday we have used the class attribute, right? In today's episode we will see how to write the CSS in different ways: external CSS, internal CSS and inline CSS. How to write the external CSS? Before going to understand the external CSS, let's discuss the internal CSS first. So here we have the h1 tag, right? And the paragraph tag inside this body tag. If you notice here, we have used the style tag inside the heading, right? Inside style tag we have the styles given to these selectors. This body is called as selector, this h1 is called as selector. So when we run this web page, what happens is it will check for the body selector. This body will take the background as red. Similarly here H1 selector will be selected inside this body tag. So wherever H1 is present, that will be given this style, color and margin left, right? So this is how CSS works. Writing the CSS inside the HTML file is called as internal CSS. This style is written inside this HTML file, right? This is one HTML file, .html file. Inside this HTML, we have this style, that's why it is called as internal CSS. What is inline CSS? Here, we have written the H1 tag, but the style is written inside this H1 tag only. So this style is called as an attribute, and these are called as values, and this is called as property, and this is called as value. Using the style attribute inside the tag is called as inline CSS. What is external CSS? Suppose here you have one HTML page. Inside this HTML page, there is no CSS written using the style tag. The style tag is written in some other file. So to connect these two files, this is HTML page and this is your style page. To connect this, we have to use this link rel as style sheet and the path of the file where it is stored. So let me show you this in practical, how to use this. For that we have to open the Visual Studio Code. Let's open this. Okay, here we have the basic structure of HTML, right? Let's create one paragraph here. This is paragraph. Okay, now here if I run this page, what will happen? Let's run this first. This is paragraph. Now what I want is, I want to give the color to this paragraph. I want to give the color to this paragraph using external CSS. Using inline CSS, we can use this way, color as red. Okay, so this is a way for writing the inline CSS inside the tag. Let's run this now. You can see the red color is applied. If I don't want to use the inline CSS, I will use the internal CSS as well, color as red. But how? Inside head tag we have to apply the style tag like this. So this is way of writing the internal CSS. Let's run this. You can do this as well. Now if I don't want to write this inside my HTML file, what I will do is, now let's see the output. This is a paragraph, this is a black color because there is no styling present here. Now what I will do is go here to your project directory. Here you have the new file, right? New file, and give file name as external.css. So make sure you add the .css extension here. Now here we will apply the style. I will use paragraph selector and color as purple. Okay. Or we can use the green color, simple. Now we have to connect both these files. So for that, as I have shown, you have to use the link rel is equals to style sheet and href is equals to the name of your external file, external.css, like this. Now if you run this, the color of this text is changed to green. How it is happening? The entire code of CSS is written inside this file, right? Now what happens is, when we write this line, all the CSS code, this entire CSS code will be written here, but we cannot see that. That will be visible only to the browser who is running this HTML, right? Similarly, if I write heading tag here, this is heading one here. Here, if I write the CSS for that as well, you can use this as well, right? It will check for H1 selector inside this file, where is H1, and assign the color as purple. Let's run this. See, you can assign multiple CSS styles as well. For example, if you want to add some internal style as well, you can do that even if the external style sheet is present. Here, if I want H1, should be of color red. But if you notice here inside this file, we have the H1 color as purple, h1 color as purple, and inside this HTML file which color is we have given? Red. So what will be the final output of this h1? This will be this red, because this is written inside this. Then that's why internal CSS will get more preference than external CSS. Similarly, if I write style is equals to here and color it as brown, so which color will be added? This purple, this red, or this brown to this h1? So the brown will be selected color, because this is more close to this h1. More closer the style, more preference will be given to that, right? If I run this now, the brown color will be added. I hope you got the basic understanding of inline, external, and internal CSS. Let's discuss about CSS selectors. So here we have 5 type of selectors: simple selectors, combinator selectors, pseudo class selectors, pseudo element selectors, and attribute selectors. Now, what basically are these? So let's discuss our first type, simple selectors. So we have the ID and class, right? While creating our first project, we have seen the class attribute, right? So let's discuss this in practical so that you get better understanding about ID and class. So simple selectors have ID and class. Let's see. If I write h1 here like this, this is heading 1. Okay, so we have the heading 1 here. What we will do is we will assign the style tag here, and inside this h1 tag we will use the class attribute like this, heading 1. Okay, so we have assigned the class name to this heading tag. Now inside the style tag here we have to use a dot. Whenever there is a class, there will be a dot and the name of the class, heading 1, and the curly brackets, right? Now what happens is, whenever the class name with this dot and this heading name will be appear like this, the style of that will be changed to this color, yellow, or we can give it as pink, like this. Similarly, if I use heading, this is heading 2, and let's give it heading 2. And to change the style of this heading 2, either I can use the class attribute or I can use the ID attribute as well. I will give it name as heading 2, and inside the style tag here, what you have to do is use the hash. Whenever there is ID, you have to use the hash and the name of the class. So what is the name of the class? It's heading 2. And the brackets here like this. So here if I give the color as brown, you can see the color is changed to brown here. We have these two simple selectors, class and ID. I hope you got the understanding of these two selectors. Whenever we have class, use the dot, and whenever we have the ID, use the hash. Okay, if I give it the same name like this, so do you get some confusion? If we give it same name, heading 1 here as well and here as well, now which style will be selected for which element? So whenever there is a dot with the name, it will be selected as a class, not this. Okay, and whenever we have the hash, this will be selected ID, and the style of this element will be changed, even if the names are same here like this. Second, we have the combinator selectors. Now, combinator selectors have subcategories. You can name it as descendant selector, which is denoted by space. Child selector is denoted by this symbol. Adjacent sibling selector is denoted by this plus symbol. And forward general sibling selector is denoted by this. Now, don't get confused while getting these names. These names are very difficult, but while using this in practical, these are very simple. Let's discuss the descendant selector. So descendant selector matches all the elements that are descendants of a specified element. Now what does that mean? Here we have div tag inside HTML, and inside that div tag we have a paragraph tag. All the paragraph tag inside this div will get the background color as yellow, but the element should be descendants. Now what does that mean? Let's run this in practical. If if I create a div here and one paragraph. This is a paragraph one. Okay. Similarly, we will create one more paragraph and I will write it as this is a paragraph two. Here, if I write a style tag, internal style for a div p and give it as a background color green like this, we will do it as yellow. What is happening here is all the div tag with paragraph will get the background color yellow by using this descendant selector. So as you can see here, we have the space between the selectors. This is div and this is p. Now what happens if I write a paragraph here after the div? This is a paragraph 3, but this is also a paragraph, but this paragraph is not getting changed with yellow color. Why? Because this is outside the div. We want only div. If I remove this div, it will select all the paragraphs. This paragraph as well, this paragraph as well, and this one as well. But if I write a div here, whenever we have the div, only that paragraph will be changed, not outside the divs. Inside this div only. So if I create one more tag inside this div tag, like section tag, this is also getting the yellow color because this is inside this div. So that's working, right? Similarly, we have the child selector. Child selector selects all the elements that are children of a specified element. Only the children of div will get the background color. What does that mean? If I remove this space with this symbol here, you can see now this paragraph color is changed now. Previously in descendant selector, the color was same here, right? Why? Because inside div, whenever there is a P, no matter where it is, inside other tag as well, there is a P. So, but that is inside the div. So all the colors will be changed here, right? But if I use the child selector, so only childs will get the advantage here. So this paragraph is the child of this div. This paragraph is also the child of this div, but this paragraph is the child of this section tag. That you need to understand. There is a hierarchy happening. This element is a child of this section tag. This paragraph is a child of this div. This div is a child of this body tag, right? Similarly, we have this paragraph has a parent body, not div. So there is a parent-child relationship in creating the HTML tag. So that you need to understand. All the childs of this div will get the background color yellow, not the other ones. So this is child selector. Adjacent sibling selector. So adjacent sibling selector selects all the elements that are adjacent siblings of a specified element. Now adjacent sibling selectors are denoted by this plus symbol. Now what does that mean? If I remove this here, you can see only the paragraph 3 is changed, this paragraph. Why? Because no matter how many paragraphs are inside this div, all these divs will be ignored. Outside this div, this is called as a sibling. So the first sibling will get the advantage of this styling property. For example here, if I write one more paragraph, this is paragraph 4. So this paragraph 4 is not getting the yellow color. Why? Because only the first sibling will get the advantage after this div. Okay. This is a second sibling. So this paragraph will not get that advantage with this adjacent sibling. But if I use the fourth format, which is general sibling selector, so all the siblings will get the color here. So this is a basic difference. If I use the adjacent sibling selector, only the first sibling will be selected after this div. And if I use this tilde symbol into your keyboard, you can see all the siblings are selected. So that's how this combination of selectors works. Combination of these selectors works. Simple selector, combinator selector. We have seen these two now. Simple and combinator. Simple selector includes id and class. Class is represented with dot and id with hash. Combinator selectors are denoted by space, greater than symbol, plus and this tilde symbol. So forward general sibling selector means it will select all the elements like this. And if I use plus, it will select only first sibling. And if I use this child, so only child elements will be selected. So this div has these two childs, and this paragraph is a child of this section, so this will not get the advantage. And if I use the space, it will select all the paragraph no matter where they are. So that's the basic difference. Now the third type of selector is pseudo elements. Now what does that mean? Here you can see the styling is different here. For example, here inside paragraph we have multiple lines. So if I want to change the CSS of only first line, we can use this. And before that we have this pseudo selector like this. This is a symbol which you need to add two times colons. Similarly, if you want to change the style of first letter only, you can use this first letter. So let's see this in practical so that you get better understanding. Let me remove this first. If I write paragraph tag here, or let's see heading tag, this is heading, or better will be paragraph because we have multiple lines. This is para 1, this is para 2. And if I add a break here like this, so we have two paragraphs here, right? Now if I want to change the color of this, I will give it as red, but I want to change the color of only first line. So for that purpose, add colon two times and write first line like this. Okay, so spacing is not working, right? We have to manage this. Be careful while writing this. So first line, and with this selector you can see only first line color is changed. If I want only first letter, that also I can see only first letter color is changed here. So that's how you can achieve this using the pseudo elements. Similarly, we have before and after. So before content will be add me before. So for that we have to see this in action. If I want to add some content dynamically, like while running the web page I want to change the content, I can use this before. And I will add the content. This is before. Here you can see before paragraph this is getting added. This content is getting added here, right? And if I use the after tag here, this you can see after this paragraph this content is getting added here like this after tag. If I add the space here, you can see after the paragraph this is getting added. This is how this content works. One more thing we will see. We have seen how to add the links into the HTML using the a tag, right? For example, we have used forgot password, and if I use the hr here, it will give it as link. Now here if I use this pseudo element like this, I want font size to be 32 pixel like this. When it will hover, so by using this hover property, whenever I bring a cursor to this, the size of this is getting changed here like this. The size of this is getting changed whenever I hover over this. The drop down is coming here, right? Similarly, you can achieve that using this hover, right? You can do it in any, like for example, if I use this paragraph here and I will give it its paragraph, so you can use it on any HTML element as well. Even if I use a class here like para, and for using the class you have to add the dot and this, so this will be applied to this. And if I add one more para here, this is paragraph para 2, and this is para 1 like this. Now only the first paragraph will get the advantage of this hover effect, but the second paragraph is not getting the effect. Why? Because we have assigned the style to this class element only, to this specific paragraph, not to this paragraph. I hope you are enjoying the episode and getting more deep insights about the CSS. In the next episode, we are going to dive deep into more selectors, and we will see the Bootstrap classes and the icons which are needed. Like this, you can see the icons here. How to add these kind of icons, that's what we are going to explore in our next lecture. And that's all for today's episode. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.